once you dah masuk, you tinggal berapa lama pun, you akan miss. You akan miss that. Benda tu becomes a part of you. Seperti macam dunia ni, dunia lakonan kita ni, bila you dah jadi ahli, you lari macam mana, you masih ahli. You will come back. Hello guys, welcome to Motive Trending. Sekarang kita bersama dengan seorang jejaka yang tengah hangat sekarang ni. He's a very cool person, very chill je, santai-santai. Idaman wanita-wanita di luar sana. We have Sharul Izzani in the house, man. Hello. Studio tepuk sikit. Yes. What's up, man? Welcome to the show, bro.
I'm happy to be here.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Saya suka dia punya energy tau. Dia macam, how do I say this? A low energy hipster person that you see on Tumblr. You know, like all those girls will be like, oh my god, this guy, man, is my dream guy, dude. Memang tu, itu vibe-vibe dia yang kita dapat tau. But it's a compliment tu. It's a compliment.
Yeah.
It is a compliment.
Thank you, thank you.
Okay, we want to ask you, why do you think you're trending? Your motive trending? Sharul rasa apa dia?
Tak tahulah, I rasa macam bila berlakon kan, macam ada certain babak-babak tu, ada certain things yang menjadi hangat untuk orang bercakap. And itulah, bila hangat bercakap tu, dia jadi suatu things that they talk about.
Yeah.
Dia komen-komen, lepas tu berlawan dalam komen, bergaduh dalam tu. tapi I guess it's good lah, at least dapat apa mempromosikan drama kita juga.
Betul, betul, betul. That's true, man. Okay, sebelum tu mungkin boleh ceritakan sikit pasal your background. Like when did you join the industry? Is it you've always wanted to join the industry or that kind of things?
Yang interesting ya. Bagi saya lah, berlakon, arts ni memang something yang saya berminat. But masa sekolah tak ada pun berfikir oh, I nak berlakon apa. Tak ada berlakon masa sekolah ada, padahal tak adalah berfikir nak jadi pelakon apa. Tapi apa yang perjalanannya, apa perjalanannya, apa yang berlaku tu, bila saya 18 tahun, saya ada pergi satu macam theater show. So lepas daripada theater show tu, masa rap tu, dia orang semua apa, ada macam-macam orang lah, ada pelakon, ada producer, ada ni semua. Saya hanya kat situ just apa, teman my family and okay, just nak enjoy show je. Tapi kebetulan ada seorang producer kat situ, dia tengok saya macam dia rasa I ada something. Dia tanya sama ada berminat ke tak pelakon. Saya macam maybe, tak tahu. So pergi casting. Pergi casting, langsung dapat role tu, langsung start berlakon.
Wow, macam tu. Straight away. Eh?
Straight away.
Dia dapat rasa ke aura tu, little bit.
Maybe.
Yeah, the vibe that you give off. And maybe you're very suitable for the role that they wanted to cast.
Yes, watak tu pun dalam cerita kami lah.
Yes,
so
kami.
That was the one lah daripada situ.
Nice, nice, nice. So, mungkin soalan ni saya kena ubah sikit. Like, I wanted to ask apa yang buat you tertarik pada industri tu, industri ni. But since you are kind of like, you headhunted in a way, right? They headhunt you in a way. They found you and then they pick you up. So dah masuk ni, apa yang buat you rasa tertarik pada industri since you already here, right?
Bagi I lah, yang interesting pasal apa industri kita ni. Masa saya first masuk tu, everything is just macam scary.
Okay.
Everything is scary nak buat. Nak berlakon is scary.
Betul.
Nak pergi promote cerita pun is scary. Nak interview, everything is scary.
Ya.
Tapi apa yang kita dapat experience tu dengan jumpa orang baru, dengan bergaul dengan kru, kita dapat apa? Berlakon, kita dapat melakonkan watak, all of those things, sebenarnya benda tu once you dah masuk, you tinggal berapa lama pun, you akan miss. You akan miss that. Benda tu becomes a part of you. Seperti macam dunia ni, dunia lakonan kita ni, bila you dah jadi ahli, you lari macam mana, you masih ahli. You will come back.
Yeah, yeah.
So, for me, yang buat I tertarik, the experiences, the energy lah.
that energy antara macam contoh kita berlakon kan, that energy yang kita share, yang kita play, benda tu yang jadi my interest.
Betul, saya pun rasa macam tu sebab to be honest, for me, like my first love is acting. Bila Sean berlakon tu, like that is the exact moment that we're talking about, right? Having create and masa kita mainkan watak tu, itu sebenarnya the joy where the actors find in that process of it, you know. Alright man, so with Kami the Movie, we know it's a big success. Boleh tak cerita tentang impact yang Kami the Movie beri pada hidupan Syarul ni?
Oh, memang cerita Kami tu was pada masa tu memang something yang macam fenomena lah.
Yeah man.
So for me, hidup I berubah. I, you know, contoh I nak keluar, just pergi mall.
Yeah.
Akan ada orang nak datang ambil gambar, ada orang ikut. And so it's, it was something yang, wish, ini very different life daripada what I'm used to. Tapi alhamdulillah, benda tu menjadi something yang peminat-peminat kat luar sana semua forever ingat. Forever ingat watak Ali, dan saya sangat bersyukur dengan benda tu. Because kalau tak ada Ali, tak adalah Syahrul Izzani berlakon tu dia.
Kau cakap apa kau nak cakap? Kau boleh simpan kau punya pas sampah. Tak payah nak berangan kau ni bagus sangat.
Betul. So that was my experience lakonan. That was my introduction to lakonan. Satu watak yang nak explore method tu, method acting tu. Kita tak ada apa kan masa tu. So kita kena explore method acting, kita kena depresskan diri, kita kena find chemistry, kita kena buat semua tu. So that was the first experience. So the first experience tu menjadi something yang forever bila I berfikir pasal berlakon, of course apa yang belajar kat situ akan menjadi part of my lakonan today.
Huge, yeah, it made a big difference in your life for sure.
Yeah,
untuk career. Obviously, impact tu memang besar dari segi your own personal life in terms of people knowing you. Like, orang dah start kenal, like you said, orang dah start kejar you kat luar and everything. How is that experience? Are you all, because you seem like a cool, almost introverted person, you know? So dengan exposure yang macam tu, it's very high energy, and orang yang kejar-kejar you memang extroverts bro. They're out there screaming, yeah, Syarul! Syarul! You know, like that kind of vibe, man. Like, macam mana? Like, how big do you think that affect your personal self in terms of how you carry yourself, pembawakan diri di mata netizen dah lepas tu?
Of course, macam you kata, I am introverted.
Okay.
I when it comes to macam apa, to show myself to the world, bergaul tu, I'm not great at it lah.
Okay.
But bila kita dalam position tu, di mana kita ada duty to our fans. Yes, as Syahrul Izzani.
But it's tough, man. So macam mana sebagai seorang introvert untuk keluarkan ataupun cari energi yang ni? Like, I think it's a good... Soalan ni baguslah untuk kawan-kawan kat luar ataupun penonton yang macam introvert. Tapi mungkin dia orang kat sekolah terpaksa buat presentation, you know? They have to find that semangat, you know? How do you handle that for yourself?
Yeah, actually, interesting pasal tu is basically presentation skills. Because that's where secara tidak langsung we're practicing. We're practicing masa kita tengah belajar tu, macam mana kita carry ourselves, mana kita open body language. So semua benda tu actually they function actually. And of course, coffee. A lot of coffee.
Yo, man. Alright. So after Kami the Movie punya like your timeline lah. Then kita pun tengok timeline you ada lama menyepi juga.
Yes.
You know, is it okay to share mana pergi and like kenapa dah hilang, you know?
Boleh.
Oh, the wanita kat luar sana dah tak ada idola nak idolakan.
Okay, I think just like all of us yang kat dalam industri ni, kita walaupun kita berlakon tu, people think what, you must be very brave to be an actor. Tapi sebenarnya kita ni semua hati tissue juga. Hati tissue. We're very critical about ourselves dalam lakonan kita.
Yes, yes.
So, masa I berlakon masa tu, ada banyak scene which maybe I struggle ke tak struggle, but I felt like I struggle nak menghayati, struggle untuk faham, appreciate, because tak ada life experience.
I see.
So masa tu susah juga because
yalah, at that time pun ada banyak offer. Okay, had to make that decision. Dia kata pengalaman hidup ni, I tak ada pengalaman hidup. One day I'm going have to berlakon jadi apa, something else yang mungkin lagi jauh daripada apa pengalaman-pengalaman yang I ada. Saya so, kata okay, I don't know for how long. Tapi I'm going to just cari that pengalaman hidup, be a normal person for a while.
Okay.
So I made that decision lah. So when I made that decision, masa tu
yalah dahsyat juga. Satu phone number tu tutup.
Oh.
The phone number yang
that
yang
people know lah.
Orang dalam industri ada. Tutup. Phone number tu tutup. Pergi study, pergi belajar. Lepas daripada pergi belajar tu, kerja dengan family pula. So I just wanted to kumpulkan all of those experiences. Tetapi yalah, even though that phone number, one phone number, phone number yang industri tahu gone, orang dapat cari juga. So ada banyak production datang. Every year mesti ada yang offer, kata
faham,
datang balik lah berlakon, datang balik. And I was like, okay, tak apa, sabar dulu, let me, you know, maybe when I'm ready I'll come back.
And benda tu went on. Memang nak kalau you know, kita kalau I tengok apa-apa movie ke apa-apa drama tu, memang I tengok, saya teringin I nak be in that kind of role, in that kind of cerita. Keinginan tu memang ada. But macam mana kita punya life happens is that kita, you know, year by year berlalu, offer tu kita tak ambil. So kerinduan tu, kerinduan berlakon, kerinduan industri kita, dunia kita tu tetap ada.
Yeah.
And kerinduan tu menjadi kekosongan dekat dalam hati kita. So what changed for me was dengan kita, you know, bekerja, I did consulting here and there. PKP. PKP was the one that changed a lot of things for me because apa yang I buat masa PKP tu, I tengok movies lah. Tengok movies, tengok drama. Itu je yang menghiburkan I masa tu.
Faham.
Sitting alone in my apartment. Tengok cerita. Dan daripada tengok tu, lama-lama mengkritik. Kenapa dia buat macam tu? Kenapa dia punya choice as an actor dia buat macam tu? Question. Bila I dah start question tu, I talk to myself, I rasa it's time. I felt that it was time. I said there's something yang kat dalam I ni yang calling me, I have to.
Yeah.
So what happened was that I cubalah yang mana contacts yang I ada, yang mana friends yang I ada masih. So I said, look, come back, what do I do? So I did everything I need, the profile, I did all of that. To start from scratch, hantar dekat production semua,
right,
hoping that someone would apa, say yes.
Yeah. So PKP was that moment lah for you to, yeah man, it's time for me to come back because saya kena isi balik kekosongan saya ni.
Yes.
Saya spend my whole 2 years dalam rumah tengok movie je. Oh, lama. So, when you menyepi time tu, are there anyone that, how to say, fans, maybe production ada, kita dengar, right? They are pestering you, they come back lah bro, dan semua macam tu. But what about fans tu? Like, are there any, I don't know, interactions with them? Or did you, macam mana?
Sentiasa. And this is why I always bersyukur sangat to have the fans yang I ada, because I rasa they never give up dengan nak pujuk si Syahrul Izzani ni, si Ali untuk datang balik berlakon.
Yes.
They never give up. Benda tu memang sangat honored lah. Secara tidak langsung memberi semangat juga for me untuk push my limits.
Okay.
As an actor.
Okay, let's talk about the future, bro. 2024. New plans for you? Anything that you can share with us?
Okay.
Upcoming projects ke?
Untuk 2024 ni, kan ada a few dramas that will come out. I got one yang kita tengah pre-pro. We're going to start shoot soon.
Nice.
Kau pun ada.
Syok pun ada dalam drama tu.
Yes. And drama tu title dia Kiblat ke Syurga.
Alhamdulillah.
So I'm quite excited juga. Tapi itulah, macam kita tak ada scene sama-sama kan.
Rasa ni tak ada kot. But hopefully I'll see
you. Request lah, kita request.
Request kita je kan. Boleh lah, boleh. Alright man. Okay, awesome bro. Looking forward to it. And I'm looking forward to see you having your Sebab drama ni bagi Sean is going to be quite, I feel lah, there's a potential untuk be something big, you know, in that sense.
Betul.
And yeah bro, I'm looking forward to see you come back again in this story.
I hope so. Happy.
Awesome bro. Okay, let's talk about the industry sikit lah. Tapi ni singkat je, very short je.
Okay.
Mungkin dalam mata Syarul, gambarkan industri hiburan kita dalam 5 perkataan.
Gambarkan?
Okay. 5 words. Short one je.
Okay. Bagi saya lah. Menghiburkan.
Menghiburkan.
Mengajar.
Mengajar.
Meneman.
Meneman.
Apa lagi?
Mengejutkan.
Mengejutkan pun ada. Mensensasikan.
Gitu. Alright man, let me go 5. Last kali mungkin ucapan untuk fans you. There's your camera right there man, roll out.
Okay, to all my fans, saya bersyukur sangat to have all of you. Terima kasih sangat support Syarul through everything, daripada nak comeback, daripada tengah buat comeback, daripada you know, all of my dramas, all of my two. Thank you so much. Kepada peminat-peminat baru, thank you. InsyaAllah tahun ni we're going to have more dramas. Let's enjoy it together and hopefully we can see each other and celebrate life.
Yes sir, there we go man. Syarul Zani everybody, studio tepuk. Yes, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you my brother.
I appreciate it bro. Terima kasih. Guys, kalau kau nak tengok the full version, jangan lupa search Motif Trending di semua platform digital gempak. Alright fam? Baik, kita nak kembali ke studio. Ready? Let's go. Back to work man.